The elephant, the largest land animal and a revered creature of Africa. There are two subspecies of African elephant, forest elephants and savanna or bush elephants. Savanna elephants are larger, with tusks that curve outward. They are typically found in the grasslands. Forest elephants typically live in rainforests. They are smaller, with rounder ears and slender tusks. Elephants are sexually dimorphic, which means that males are larger than females. However, both genders still have tusks, though the males may be bigger. Elephants require a lot of space to live in, a lot of water, and of course a lot of food. They can eat over 100 pounds of food in a day. Male elephants live alone, roaming as they mature. However, most elephants live in groups called clans. These clans are usually around 10 elephants, made up of closely related females and their offspring. The leader of the clan is the oldest female, called the matriarch. Elephants have three known predators: lions, hyenas, and humans. But elephant populations in Africa have been dwindling rapidly due to poaching. CITES, the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species, declared the African elephant an endangered species in 1989. There is an international ban on selling ivory. However, the ivory is still very valuable, and more elephants are being slaughtered for their tusks. In 1979, there were over 1.3 million elephants in Africa, but today, there were only 470,000 to 690,000 remaining, and their population declines at 8% annually. The African elephant's range used to extend from below the Sahara Desert to the tip of South Africa, but today, their range is limited to protected areas of national parks and game reserves. A big reason ivory poaching is still in business is that there is a huge market for it in China. Older new rich there buy ivory because it is associated with prestige. They want to flaunt their new status with the expensive ivory. There is also, sadly, a large market in the United States, such as Chinatowns in San Francisco and Honolulu. There is also a large market on the internet, as well as a big market for ivory in Thailand. Many African countries have good conservation programs. However, many do not have the resources to effectively manage and protect their elephant populations from poachers. Also, often the poachers carry heavier artillery than the rangers trying to catch them. There are other problems related to poaching besides population decline. Lone males are harder to find, so poachers often go for the matriarchs of the clans, since they are more easily located and have larger tusks. But this leaves a clan without the leadership and knowledge of the matriarch. Clans start to wander, and many leave the protected areas. This often leads them into conflict with humans, and with previous experience with poachers, the elephants are more likely to fight to the death. Scientists are also testing the effects of poaching on stress levels. However, there may be a solution to the poaching problem with science. The University of Washington Center for Conservation Biology with Dr. Samuel Wasser have made important discoveries and have developed a system for finding where poachers are getting their ivory. First, they use tracking dogs in the Conservation Canines program, which was pioneered by Dr. Wasser. These are very high-energy dogs, like this one. These dogs track elephant scat out in the wild. Using tracking dogs allows biologists to cover a lot of ground. Scat is also a much easier tracking method than traditional ways, and it's easy to collect. The scientists can observe much about their subjects without even seeing them. A lot of different information is available in the scat, such as hormone levels and nutrition, but the most needed information was the DNA. Many pieces of DNA are found in scat because the cells in our guts are often renewing themselves. The scientists take these DNA samples and search them for short tandem repeats, or microsatellites. Microsatellites are short repeating sections in non-coding areas of DNA. For example, the most common STR is the GC repeat. These microsatellites vary widely between the elephants, based on distance and time. The farther apart the elephants are from each other, and how long they've been separated, determines how varied their microsatellites are. The scientists analyzed many different samples of DNA, and got it down to 16 major short tandem repeats for the elephants. These 16 are the easiest to amplify, and they have the most important variety. They then used the DNA in the scat samples to create a genetic map for which elephants were located in different regions of Africa. The next step comes when a shipment of tusks has been confiscated. DNA must be extracted from the tusks. The scientists take a small piece of a tusk. The piece is washed and bleached before it will be put into a freezer mill. The tusk piece is inside a metal tube along with a magnet. The tube is put into the freezer mill into liquid nitrogen, which is extremely cold. This keeps the DNA from being denatured. A magnetic coil surrounds the tube. The magnetic field is rapidly switched back and forth, which smashes the magnet around inside the tube. This smashes up the tusk until it becomes powder. This makes the small pieces of DNA inside accessible. However, the segments of DNA from the tusks are too small to work with. They need to be multiplied or amplified using polymerase chain reaction, or PCR. To do PCR, you need the target DNA, which is the microsatellites. Primers, forward and reverse. These attach to the DNA and tell the DNA polymerase where to start reading. DNA polymerase. This reads the DNA and builds new strands. Nucleotides. These are used to build the new strands of DNA. Buffer. This stabilizes the pH and keeps it from getting too acidic or too basic. This would denature the DNA polymerase. For PCR, TAC polymerase is used, which is an enzyme that produces DNA polymerase. It is needed because it is an extremophile and can survive in the intense heat needed for the process. The DNA starts out at room temperature. Then it is heated to 94 degrees Celsius. This denatures the DNA. Next, the temperature drops to 55 degrees. This allows the primers to anneal. A forward and reverse primer are needed because the DNA polymerase can only read the DNA in a 5' to 3' direction, so the bottom DNA strand is read in reverse. After the primers anneal, it's heated back up to 72 degrees. The DNA polymerase comes in, reads the DNA, and builds new strands. This process is then repeated 25 to 40 times. The samples are then run in a gel. Once the microsatellite's length is determined, it's matched up to the genetic map of microsatellites over Africa made from the scat samples. This tells the scientists where the poachers got that piece of ivory. Other actions that would help would be the creation of wildlife conservation corridors. This would create protected areas for the elephants to be able to move more freely without clashing with humans. Science is leading the way to helping conserve African elephants.